A U.S. veteran shot by police after he refused to put his weapon down has the medical community addressing the effects of post-traumatic stress disorder.
Action 7 News reporter Christy Aletto explains how PTSD can have a mind of its own while taking over the minds of the soldiers.
And Shelley Doug, the Veterans Affairs Medical Center couldn't tell us much except for saying they make a personal investment in each soldier they counsel. But we spoke with a commander with the Military Order of the Purple Heart for New Mexico who helped us explore the minds of soldiers with post-traumatic stress disorder.
I said, Mom, I'm in front of the 7-Eleven on Eubank Constitution with a gun to my head. The police are here.
Those were Kenneth Ellis's last words to his mother before he was shot and killed by police Wednesday morning. We learned Ellis was suffering from PTSD and was not allowed back to his inpatient program at the VA hospital after missing some appointments.
Everybody who breaks a rule does not get kicked out of the program. Our first response is to work with the veterans to try to keep them in the program.
The VA hospital would not give out any details about Ellis and his condition, but Vietnam veteran Peter Comstock was able to shed some light on soldiers with PTSD.
They've seen more hours of combat than we Vietnam veterans, Korea, and World War II combined. It's serious for them. And the trust issue is a real problem.
Comstock is with the Purple Heart Order of New Mexico, a group that mentors soldiers returning from combat. He says sometimes soldiers feel like suicide is the only option.
When it goes dark for them, that's how they feel, like they're the only ones that have this problem.
A problem that's becoming more prevalent with soldiers returning from overseas. Now the VA tells us that Operation Iraqi Freedom is the first war where soldiers get a formal mental diagnosis, both before and after combat, and also after their discharge. Now Vietnam veterans didn't get those evaluations as soon. They were done much later when they returned from combat.